Welcome to Chemistry with Caroline. In this video, we're going to look at how to draw resonance structures and the accompanying arrows to show the movement of electrons for their formation for neutral molecules. So students often ask, where do I start if the molecule is neutral? A thing to look for is a carbon heteroatom double bond. So carbon is going to be less electronegative than pretty much any other non-metal heteroatom that it's attached to. And so there's going to be a dipole moment facing towards X. It's going to have a higher affinity for electrons, and that pi bond can go out and reside as a lone pair of electrons on the X atom. So what I have in my example molecule is a carbonyl functional group, so a C double bond O. The oxygen has a higher affinity for the electrons, so the pi bond can shift up onto the oxygen as a lone pair of electrons, forming a charge-separated species. And so that is just when I have a positive and a negative charge adjacent to one another. So if the oxygen gains electrons, the carbon loses electrons, and that forms a carbocation. And once that's formed, now we have a spot to put electrons. And so the pi bond that's adjacent to the carbon with the carbocation on it can come over and fold in to make a new double bond there. So now we're inside the ring, and we're going to be able to go all the way around the ring in a benzene ring like this. So this carbon would be positively charged. Now the pair of electrons in the pi bond next door to it can fold down, and that will form this structure. And again, the pi bond that's adjacent to the newly formed carbocation can fold in. And that gives us this structure. And then students often ask, well, how do I know that I'm done? So with cyclic structures, often what happens is you'll pop back outside the ring. So this pi bond here can fold in, and now the ring is going to be neutral again. And you'll be back to having a charge on the carbon outside the ring and the oxygen. So what happens is essentially all of the pi bonds in my benzene ring have shifted. And I've already had my charges on that structure right there. So the overall character of this molecule is such that there is a partial positive charge or less electron density at all of these positions and more electron density on the oxygen. The actual molecule is not any of these discrete molecules. It's a weighted average of all of them. The fact that we draw individual Lewis structures to represent the resonance of the molecule is a limitation of Lewis structures. But being able to draw them is very important for organic chemistry. So when you're doing these types of problems, look for your carbon X double bond for any neutral molecule, so you know where the electron density should lie. Don't exceed the octet rule for second row elements, and each structure should have the same formal charge all the way through. So the overall formal charge should be the same. So this has been a look at how to draw resonance structures for neutral organic molecules. If you found this video helpful, please like, subscribe, and share with your friends. Thanks.